This is the BBC Home Service. And jolly good programs they put on, too.
Oh, isn't he a lovely talker?
Thank you. Could you say some more, mister, please?
Why, certainly. This is Wallace Greenslade saying, winds light to variable. Oh, Greenslade, how can they afford you?
Because 12 shillings a week is nothing to the highly esteemed Goon Show! Thank you, listeners. Next dance, please. Mr. Greenslade, loosen that plastic sporran and make the announcements.
Listeners and listeners, we present an ancient Chinese play translated from an old Greek soup recipe found engraved on the seat of a dustman's trousers in East Acton. The trousers can now be inspected in the Science Museum internal combustion section. This play was especially written for the wireless.
Wireless, curse! This means the end of the horned phonograph and the little doggy that looks into it. Exit slip.
Hello, you there. Oh, boy, get this. We give you, and how, one hot story of all hometown. Okay, Wally, take it away. Overture and beginners for China Story. Oh, boy.
Strange people, the Chinese. There are over 500 million of them.
Well, they've only got themselves to blame.
Thank you, Registrar of Births. My name is Nettie Seagoon, though my charlady calls me Ducks, due to a certain disease I have. I'm well known in China and voted best dressed man of 1904 in 1955. Yes. It was Christmas night on the waterfront of Shanghai. Still, it had to come sometime. Yes. As I walked the crowded streets, people seemed to know I was British. Was it my bearing? The cut of my dentures? Or was it the 8-foot floodlit Union Jack tied round my head? I'll never know.
Yikes, tally-ho, nutty. Have a noodle.
The words came from a two-legged, grey-headed man going bald at the knees. He was bent backwards, eating a plate of unchopped suey from a leopard-skin bladder. With a wave of his foot, he beckoned me over.
He ignored my invitation, but then I said something that had him at my side. Money!
My name is Ned Siegel.
Have a noodle.
Thank you. You, called me over?
Yes.
What do you want?
Well, you have a kind face.
You can't have it. It's a fixture.
Fixture, eh? My, you are lumbered.
Have a care, sir. I'm not a man to be laughed at.
I know. I've seen your act. Singing shaver, isn't it?
I have my dark secrets.
Man, so do I.
Silence, Ellington, or I'll have the whitewash brush to you.
Well said, Neddy. Oh, Neddy, this gentleman here is Count Moriarty, French overland saxophone champion.
Je suis très content d'avoir fait votre connaissance et j'espère que nous serons ensemble pour longtemps.
So, the pen of your aunt is in the garden, eh? You're a stranger in China, eh, lad?
Stranger? I came here as a boy.
I didn't think you came here as a girl. Oh, I don't know, though. You Chinese are damn clever people.
I'll have you know I'm English.
English? But that ragged kilt and your toes sticking out the end of your feet.
In my position, that's no shame.
You're not?
Yes, the British ambassador.
Poor fellow, you must be starving. Have a noodle.
Thank you.
Waiter, two iced rickshaws and a firkin of rice. So, you're the British ambassador.
Yes.
There'll always be an England, and England shall be free. If England means as much to you as England means home.
silly, twisted boy.
They wish to know that. Do we take it, Mr. Sneagle, that you are pressed for money?
Yes.
Hmm. Interesting, eh, Colonel Gritpipe?
Yes. Come, Neddy, have another noodle.
Thank you.
Neddy, how would you like 50 million yen?
In cash.
Crazy boy, Sigun. You've heard of the fiendish Chinese nationalist leader?
Not General Cash My Check.
Yes. Listen, lad, he's willing to pay that sum to anybody who can smuggle him a certain English rosewood upright piano with brass cattle holders.
Tell me more, gentlemen.
Well, Neddy, this is the plan.
Pardon me, kind sirs. Will you three gentlemen be sitting here for the next few minutes?
Yes.
I'm only a strolling vagabond. So good a night, pretty maiden, oh good a night. I'm bound for the hills and the valleys beyond. So good a night, pretty maiden, oh good a night. Oh good a night. Oh good a night. Oh good a night. Oh pretty maiden, oh good a night.
Yes. Now, Sigun, this is the idea we have.
Gentlemen, you heard my melody. And I think that this little wooden box with a slit in the top speaks the poetic soul.
Yes. Neddy, the first thing you have to do...
Gentlemen, I understand. You want an uncle. Oh, joy. Oh, a gypsy am I, a wandering boy.
Well done, Moriarty. Just check the little wooden box, would you? Now, see, June, think our offer over, and I'll get in touch with you on the phone tomorrow.
Till tomorrow, then. Back at the embassy, I pondered over Gritpipe Thin's offer. Why on earth did General Cash My Check want a certain English upright rosewood piano with brass candle holders? Calling people the fiendish Chinese? You never know which way they're going to go. I was just about to retire for the night. When there was a tap at the window. Hello? Hello? Anybody out there in the dark?
I'm all so...
Cut him! Hello?
Call for you, you're through.
Hello?
So good a night. What did he mean?
Blast that man!
Sir, this record has just arrived marked urgent.
Quick, put it on.
So good a night. What did he mean?
A pox on the man! Yes?
Neddy, Gritpipe Thin here. Have you made a decision about the certain English upright?
Yes. I need the money. I'll do the job. But where do I get that certain English upright rosewood piano with brass candle holders?
Go to the tea house of the August Goon.
Just a minute, I'll take that down. Go to the tea house of the August... There, right.
Got that down?
Yes.
Burn it at once.
Right.
Now set fire to the ashes.
Yes. Yes, I've done that.
Good. Now memorize the remains.
Right.
Splendid. Now say after me, I am an idiot.
I am an idiot.
Right. Now when you arrive there, knock 6,000 times and ask for our pong.
But how do I get there?
How do you get there? Where are you now?
I'm standing by the phone.
Good. Start asking your way from there.
Thank you. I should be there in 3 minutes. Just enough time for a fiendish Chinese gentleman, Malax Glendalay, to have a blowout.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.